Hi all, today we are going to see the verification of NOT gate using IC in your laboratory. So for that we need a breadboard. So you can see we need a breadboard. So for this I am using one IC. That IC number is 74HC14 IC, which is nothing but a NOT gate. So along with that I am using the two LEDs and two 1 kilo ohm resistors, and I am using 5 wires and 1 9 volts battery. I am repeating the components that are required again. We need one breadboard and one IC. That IC number is 74HC14, which is a NOT gate, 1 9 volts battery, and the connecting leads for the battery. And then 3 wires are required, 2 LEDs are required, and 2 1 kilo ohm resistors are required. So now coming to the IC, how you will detect the IC? So for that you can see this is the IC. So in the IC you can see in the top side there is a notch. So whichever side there is a notch, you can see this side there is a notch. So this I am keeping on the top side. So if you are holding like this, then we will detect the pins. You can see the pins on this IC. There are 7 pins in each side, total 14 pins are there. So and the number of the IC will be written on the IC. So I am assuming that you already have the idea about this. So let us see the physical interpretation of this IC. So if you see the IC here, the notch is kept on the top, then internal circuit will be like this. From between pin number 1 and 2, 1 will act as the input, 2 will act as the output for the NOT gate. Similarly, 3 will act as the input, 4 will act as the output, there is one more NOT gate. Similarly, between 5 and 6, 1 NOT gate will be connected. Similarly, between 9 and 8, 11 and 10 and 13 and 12, those pin numbers the NOT gate is connected. So in order to operate this IC, we have to give the supply to that. So that needs one positive terminal and one negative terminal. You can see the plus 5 volts is given to pin number 14. That means to pin number 14 we have to connect plus 5 volts, that is called as plus VCC. And to pin number 7 we have to connect the ground. For pin number 7 we have to connect the ground, then this IT will be operational. But as we have only 9 volts battery, so in order to get the required 5 volts or even 4.5 volts it is working. For that what I am going to do, I am going to connect 2 resistors in series. That means I am going to use 2 1 kilo ohm resistors in series. When you connect 2 1 kilo ohm resistors in series across the battery, we know that voltage will divide among them. So each 1 kilo ohm resistor, the voltage will be nearly equal to 4.5 volts. So that 4.5 volts I am going to take the tapping and connect there. So for that what I am doing, I am taking the IC. So this particular IC I have connected here already in the breadboard. What you have to do, you have to just keep it on the breadboard and insert it. So you have to insert it, because inserting takes time, that's why I have pre-inserted it to save the time. So let us try to make the connections. So this is my battery. So from the battery you have to take the positive and negative terminals. So this is my positive terminal, this positive connection I have connected here, and a negative terminal I have connected here. Negative terminal I have connected here, positive terminal I have connected here. So let us see the other connections now. So now we have to use 2 1 kilo ohm resistors to make the voltage division. So let us try to make the voltage division. So for this, how to use the breadboard, already you have idea. So we have to connect from this point. Let us assume I am connecting to some another point. So I have connected this one between these two points. So now another one more 1 kilo ohm resistance I am taking. So I am connecting between this point and the ground. So while inserting, you have to insert properly, otherwise the leads of the resistor will damage. So you have to be cautious about that one. So now we can see that these are connected in series. So as these are connected in series, now the voltage will be divided among them. So to verify that whether voltage is dividing or not, I am using the multimeter. So for this you can use any multimeter whichever you have. So for example, I have this multimeter which is also some local made. So how to use the multimeter already known to you. So you have to connect in DC voltage. I have connected in 20 volts. So when you connect in DC volts, 20 volts, let us see voltage across these resistors. So positive terminal is connected to this red color wire, and second terminal is connected to this black color wire. You can see here nearly 4.6 volts is coming. Clearly between the second one also nearly 4.6, because this multimeter has an error and battery also exactly not 9, it is showing like this. That means they are connected in series and they are working properly. So now we have to take the tapping from there. So I told you that plus VCC should be connected to pin number 14. So for that I am taking my positive terminal from here, because I am taking across the second 1 kilo ohm resistance that I am using for supplying the VCC. As this is connected, all these are connected together, I am connecting here. Getting it? So this is connected. So now the negative terminal. So the negative should be connected because this is a bus bar. It will be connected like this up to here. So I am taking this from here. I am taking the tapping to take the minus terminal. So that the ground will be connected to pin number 7. So I have connected to pin number 7. Okay, it is clear to you. So now coming to the measuring the value, because output we have to measure. For that I am using the LEDs. Again, the LED, if you take any LED that I am showing here, you can see the LED will have two terminals. So one terminal will be little longer than the second one. You can see this terminal is little longer than the second one. This is one way you can analyze. And second way, you can see from inside. So inside there will be terminals, whichever is the smaller one inside. I don't know whether it is focusing properly or not. So inside, whichever the smaller one is there, that is considered as the positive terminal. Or simple way you can tell that, whichever lead is long, that is the plus, whichever lead is short, that is minus. Because generally the operation of this LED will operate efficiently up to 2.2 volts. So as we are giving nearly 4.5, 4.5 will come. So I am using two LEDs in series. So for that I am just making the connections here. Let us assume this LED is connected like this, plus in the left hand side and right, minus in the right hand side. So similarly I want to connect one more. So again I am taking another LED. You can see the longer one. So this is the longer one, this is the positive. So this one is connected again here, and this minus is connected to the ground point. So for this I am connecting to the ground point. Okay, and you have to remember that while making the connections, you should be cautious. It is connected properly, otherwise it will not work. So now the LEDs are connected. So from these LEDs, I need an output. So let us use the pin number 1 and pin number 2. So pin number 2 is the output. That pin number 2, I am using the wire. Through the wire, I am connecting pin number 2 to this point. So pin number 2 means this is the second one. So second one I am taking. So this pin number 2, I am just making the connection. Okay, so the output is connected. So now the IC is connected, output is also connected. So now if you connect the input accordingly, the output will come. If LED is glowing, that means output is 1. If LED is not glowing, then output will be 0. So in that way we can detect it. Getting it? So now I am making the connection to the positive one, or connection to the input. So input will be connected to pin number 1. I have connected to pin number 1. So depending on where you are connecting the input, it will either give the output as 1 or 0. So before proceeding, let us do the truth table. The truth table tells that if your input is 0, then output will be 1. If your input is 1, output will be 0. So you can see that when I am connecting this, if I am connecting to the ground, so that means the input is given as 0. That means 0 volts, that means input is 0. The output, you can see the LEDs are glowing. Similarly, if I am connecting to the positive terminal, that means positive terminal means plus VCC, that means I am connecting to 5 volts or 4.5 volts, output is equal to 0. That means when you are giving the input as 1, output is equal to 0. If you are giving the input as 0, output is equal to 1. In this way you can verify. So same thing is the case. Let us check for another pin. So pin number 1, 2 is over. Now 3, this is 4. So pin number 4 I am taking as the output. So pin number 3 I am taking as the input. So whenever you connect this pin number 3 to the positive terminal, so in that case you can see output is coming as 0. So let us see, I have connected to the plus. So whenever you connect this pin number 3 to ground, or don't connect it, so in that case output is coming as opposite. As input is 0, output will be equal to 1. So similar way, because I have connected between pin number 3 I have taken as input, 4 as the output. Similarly, you can perform for the other pins. So I hope this is completely clear to you. I am just repeating what things are required. This IC number is 74HC14. So these ICs are available in the market. I purchased from the market for about 10 rupees. So along with the IC, breadboard and other kit, I think you have already purchased. So you can perform this experiment easily. So if they are available nearby in the market, you can perform it. And how to perform these logic gates using the software, that I will explain after completing all these hardware experiments. I hope that everything is clear up to now. If you still have any queries, you can leave your comments in the comment section below. I will answer to your queries from there. Thank you. Thank you very much.